Hello. That's Samael, of course. We recognize him from the first game.
Chad Council sends only one horseman, even to the past. No, this visit is unsanctioned. In fact, no one knows you're here.
Not a soul.
Oh, holy cow.
Hand over the key, it can be our little secret.
To remember how to fight him. I think that's all I'm supposed to do is dodge that shit. This part is actually fairly easy from what I remember. I've in the past remember being able to get through this without taking any damage at all. Obviously not this time. That's not what I was talking about. That part's not the hard part. I just wasn't paying enough attention. It's here as we start getting less and less of a stage to fight on. He just starts zapping my strength. Ugh! Ugh! Oh, he knocked me into the... Hello. He knocked me into the lava. Yep, I know this is the hardest part of the game, really. I don't think even the boss fight, the final boss fight. I'm pressing B. Okay. Seeing if I'm good about this. See those curves to me. I gotta play this somewhat defensively. Oh, damn it. Nope! Away from him. Ah, goddammit. I wasn't ready for that. See, that electric is what does it. Damn it! I was trying to dodge away. But it's a bit complicated when you don't know which way he's coming from. So he could be teleporting behind me or he could be in front of me. Hit him! What are you doing? Follow him with his camera doing whatever the hell it wants. Timing. God damn it. No, get away from the... This fight is infuriating to me. Because the way he teleports, you never know if he's going to be behind you or in front of you. There's not really any pattern to it. You kind of just have to learn whether he's going to attack again. Or if he stopped attacking. Like, it's... Yeah. The Chad count. There we go. Okay. Last time it wasn't letting me skip that, so there's gonna be a cut there. Damn it. Yeah, how he does that, you have to just kind of learn if it's a two-prong attack or a three. just have to kind of, like, you don't... There's nothing signifying it beforehand, you just figure it out based on how he lands. And then, of course, when he starts to raise his foot, you need to get the hell out of there. Nope. See, and that's the thing, because he can teleport anywhere, sometimes you dodge right into him. Okay. So again, I've gotten that without taking any real damage. Okay, we got it that time. Ah. I don't know if that actually accomplishes anything. Such a jerk. I'm gonna troll them with these guys for a bit. Ah, damn it. Damn it! The second you get hit by one of those, you're just kind of fucked. God damn it. They're not helping. God damn. Because of that fight frustrates me. You succeed after all.
Either way, it will be quiet. quite a show.
All right. I actually don't recognize that one. I don't know that I ever played that. Okay. So now here we are. And we are still in the past, I guess. Okay, so let's see what Crowfather has to tell us.
Crowfather. Then at last you may enter the Well of Souls. But once undertaken, there is no returning on this path.
I've come this far, Crowfather. I'm not turning back.
Then be warned, Rider of Death. A dark presence guards the well, and the seeds of corruption writhe within.
Well is corrupted.
Yes, but not the nameless kind you have faced thus far. Corruption has chosen a champion, a voice to sound its clarion call.
Then I will see this finished, here and now.
Remember what you have learned, Ryder. Corruption is the end of all things. Even death.
Tree, the keys, the well. Why do I get the sense you are testing me?
You test yourself, old friend, for what you've done. For what you had to do. And now you face the ultimate test. Will you bring death or give life?
It's a good thing I got this ability to split into two pieces. Say, actually, there's one more thing I want to do. Before we jump into there, let's refill our health. That dungeon is a lot shorter than I remember. Wait, where are we? Oh, it took us all the way. Rather than putting us nearby. So we've seen a lot of these. Those are like 100%ing stuff.
Rouse to your heart's content.
Okay. Like I said, in the future, before we jump into the ending here, in the future, I'm not gonna write off coming back here if people in the comments want me to come back and probably not 100% the game, but finish up a lot of the optional dungeons that I've skipped over and stuff like that. I can certainly do that at some point in the future. For now, we're just gonna go ahead and jump into the end of the game. The Well of Souls. So yes, we're now in here. Take care of the corruption. And one thing I will say is this game kind of loses
its past. Have you ever wondered,
Death,
why you are untouched while those around you wither and rot in the grip of corruption? Could it be that you are already blackened by the sin of betrayal? How can you defeat that which seethes in your own heart? You cannot stop me without forever damning your soul!
If you say so.
Then so be it.
I'm not entirely sure how you're hitting me with these attacks. Kinda like a T-Rex. It's even bigger now. So let's flip this out. As you can see, I'm not really doing a whole lot of damage with that, but one plus side is that I don't take a lot of damage either. This matchup, by the way, if you have life drain weapons, this matchup is super easy. But it seems like they pretty much all but cut those out with a new version. The fight against Samael is actually giving me more trouble. I say as I get killed. Oh, what? The problem is if you get to the part where you're triple jumping, see, I got grabbed too close to him, I didn't have time to react. So that attack is absurd. I gotta make sure he doesn't get me with that again. Are you kidding me? Here, deal with those guys. Jesus. Yes. His last little bit of health is taking a long time. Damn it! Not cool. Not cool at all. There we go. Okay, so that wasn't super easy, but I did still manage to get it the first try.
Take my hand once more, brother.
Oh, that's weird. That audio is all left side. Never. Okay. The big boss. Stroll in the demonic park. And four, my brother. Four is then the number four.
I've killed Absalom. Stopped the corruption. I stand at last at the Well of Souls. We've no idea what I must do next. It is quite simple. And yet, most difficult. I'm in no humor for riddles, Crowfather. You may tap the power of the well to return the kingdom of man, or you may resurrect the Nephilim. But know that choosing one will forever doom the other. My brother War. I would protect him above all. To return man to the earth, will require a sacrifice. Thus, from death came life, and the seeds of humanity will be sown. But death's journey was not ended. His brother War had slain the Destroyer.
You will be hunted. The White City for certain. The Council, and there will be others. You would wage this war alone?
No. Not alone. War had broken the Seventh Seal, summoning the Horsemen of the Apocalypse. And the number of the Riders shall ever be four.
Alright, so... Oh, so they're doing an original credits and then updated credits. Joe Madureira there, however you pronounce his name, is actually the artist lead. He was a comic book writer. Comic book artist, I should say. I don't know, he probably did some writing too, for all I know. But, so we do have some little kind of strange stuff here. Obviously it ends with, it doesn't really have its own ending. It ends with a reminder of how the first game ended. And then, like, it does that to be like, oh, don't worry, death isn't actually dead here. But it actually would have worked better if instead of the motion comic style, if they had just shown the scene from the first Darksiders. That last boss fight, as I mentioned before, the fight against Samael is a lot harder than that one. So that fight almost feels like a little bit of an afterthought. I'm sure it wasn't, but it does, it absolutely doesn't feel as profound. So that's it. That's we're finally through Darksiders. It only took us 6 months or so. I want to thank everybody for bearing with me on this. It has not been like a super easy route to get this done. Of course, there's the whole problem where we were playing it and then the whole thing crashed, and I lost several hours of support. And or support of progress. I lost a good half an hour, but it was an important half an hour of progress. And so I had to replay to show you guys that fight against the Colossus, because that is actually probably the coolest part of this whole game. It's hardly like super unique or anything, but it's one of, in my mind, it's one of the more enjoyable parts. And then, of course, we came out. We've been doing other games in the meantime. So we now. It's worth noting the company that made this, and you can tell right here, THQ Montreal. THQ is gone. Relic is gone, Vigil Games is gone. So the actual THQ is the publisher. They're responsible basically for distribution and largely the funding the project. And Vigil Games was a developer underneath them who actually developed the entire game. When THQ went out of business, so did Vigil Games. Vigil Games actually then was kind of reformed as Crytek USA, which has since gone out of business again. You feel really bad for these people, because they made some pretty good games. You know, nothing, this isn't anything spectacular, like crazy insane, it's just a solid, fun game. And There's maybe too much of an emphasis on being wild and crazy and not enough on solid gameplay. And this has pretty solid gameplay compared to a lot of games out there. But yeah, so Crytek USA is gone, but I believe Joe Mad has started his own studio. And some other people from THQ have started another studio, and some of them are working at Epic now, I think. And it's, like I said, it's all kind of sad that they split up. The Darksiders license is now owned by Nordic Games. And if you haven't heard of Nordic Games, then join the club. Nordic, they actually had to buy... They actually bought the license to use the THQ name on their games because nobody has any idea who Nordic is. So, but they own this they own the license to this. Theoretically, there is a Darksiders 3 or a third Darksiders game in development. But kind of the rumor is that this game was launched as a kind of testing ground to see if people are actually still interested in that. I don't know, by that I mean the definitive. Still feel like that should be definitive. Just feels better on my tongue. But so if any of them happen to watch this, I am, I totally am. I would love to have another one of these games. Actually, when this game came out, I bought the special edition. I have the Death Mask sitting on top of my my dresser, actually. It's the kind of thing, if I had like a solid workspace, I would bring it in for that, but because I'm only in school, I don't get to really have my own workstation. Definitive credits. Gunfire Games. So Gunfire Games is one of the studios that was created out of the falling apart of this. So I don't know, if you like that style of gameplay, it's kind of interesting because they just kind of throw everything at the wall and see what sticks. And there's a certain caliber to that. Oh, and we got an end credits scene.
You're alone, Lilith. Where are my Nephilim?
My prince, I...
The end war is upon us, yet instead of the army you promised me, death has returned man to the balance.
I await your punishment.
This time, Lilith, you will get no pleasure from it.
Nightmare mode. So that's just a higher difficulty. So Lilith, no. So Lilith, of course, is the lady that we come across actually pretty early on while I was recording this, but point is, Lilith. Oh, that was weird. Lilith was hooking up with Samael, and that voice you heard at the end there was the Dark Prince, or whatever they called the devil himself, because we've only seen the Destroyer, and the Destroyer is not the same as the devil. The Destroyer is more similar to the Antichrist. But if you guys don't remember, the Destroyer was the big bad in the first game. He was actually Abaddon, who was an angel that started the End War. He was basically tricked by the forces. He was tricked by Lilith. Let's put it like that. He was tricked by Lilith into starting the End War, and then she tricked him. After the apocalypse had happened, she tricked him into becoming the Destroyer. Or she bribed him, or whatever. Oh, excuse me. But alright, I don't really have anything else to say about this. Hopefully there will be a Darksiders 3 at some point in the future, and hopefully it will be actually a multiplayer game, because it is the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. And I know for a fact the reason they didn't make Darksiders 2 a four-player game is budget. It was just too expensive to make four main characters. And I'm not entirely sure what a four-player Darksiders game would even look like, really. But, okay. Well, so now that we're done with that, we're going to have to come up with some different Let's Plays, because all we got going on now is XCOM. And we're actually getting close to the end of the first XCOM, and XCOM 2 will be coming out. So if you ever have any suggestions for games I should play or anything like that, let me know. I do the Let's Tries. I do full playthroughs. I'd like to have more time to do more, but right now this is... right now I'm spending more time doing this than I can actually afford. But alright everybody, we will catch you on the next series of episodes. So thank you for watching, check out some of my other Let's Plays, and we will see you again soon.